Memory is a storage part of the computer system. So here the memory and storage devices are measured in terms of bits and bytes. The primary memory is also called main memory, or it's also called physical memory. And the primary memory is classified into two types, that is read-only memory and random access memory. Hello to all, a warm welcome to my new session. I am Revati, faculty, Department of Computer Science, Vidyashram, Pre-University College, Temple of Excellence, Mysuru. We are on the sixth session of Chapter 2, and the chapter name here is Input, Output and Memory Device. Moving further, in my today's session, I'm going to discuss what is memory. Along with that, I'm going to discuss the different types of memory. Along with that, I'm going to discuss what is primary memory and the types of primary memory. Before going to start my today's session, let me to recall the things what I had discussed in my previous session. In my previous session, I started with what is printer. Along with that, we had discussion regarding what is impact printer and what is non-impact printer. Along with that, we had discussion regarding the characteristics of printer. Then we had discussion regarding some of the examples of non-impact printer. In that, we had discussed what is thermal printer and the features of thermal printer, and what is laser printer and the features of laser printer, what is inkjet printer, what are the features of inkjet printer. Along with that, we had discussion regarding plotter printer and the working procedure of plotter printer. Moving further, in my today's session, I'm going to start with memory. So, dear student, now tell me what is memory and why I require memory. Suppose if I consider human, then where I can able to find the memory? Dear student, if I consider human, then where I can able to find their memory? So, if I consider human being, then memory is nothing but the brain. So, brain is used to store all the data and used to recall all the data. If I consider computer system, then where I can able to store the data? By using memory. So here, memory is the space I can able to store the data before processing, and I can able to store the result after processing. That means here, memory is a space that is mainly used to store the input data before processing and store the result or store the output after processing. So here, memory is a storage part of the computer system. I can use storage part or storage space. Both are same. So here, memory is nothing but the storage space of computer system. We need memory to store the data. That means why I required memory? Because I want to store the data. Then I required memory. That means I can able to store the data in my computer memory. By using storage or memory, I can able to use the data for future use. Here, data are stored in the memory is permanent or it may be temporary. Computer memory is mainly divided into two types, that is primary memory and secondary memory. So when I say it is primary memory, just remember that it is volatile memory. And when I say it is secondary memory, then it is called non-volatile memory. So here the memory and storage devices are measured in terms of bits and bytes, and the measurement is made by using zeros and ones. That is nothing but binary digit, that is zero as well as one. So here memory is nothing but the storage space where the user can able to store the data and the user can able to recall the data. Moving further, I'm going to have the types of memory. That is nothing but the computer memory is classified into two types, that is primary memory and secondary memory. So here the primary memory is called volatile memory and the secondary memory is called non-volatile memory. Now tell me, what is volatile memory? That is temporary memory, whereas non-volatile memory is permanent memory. Where non-volatile memory is permanent memory. And the primary memory is further classified into RAM and ROM. So what is RAM? Here RAM is random access memory. And here ROM is read only memory. Further, RAM is classified into SDRAM and DRAM. What is SDRAM? Here SD stands for static RAM, whereas D stands for dynamic RAM. Once again, the ROM is classified into three types, that is PROM, EPROM, EEPROM. And here the secondary memory is classified into hard disk, secondary storage device, compact disk, floppy disk and magnetic tape. Dear student, in my today's session, I'm going to deal with only primary memory and RAM, that is random access memory. And in my next session, I'm going to deal with ROM. Along with that, I'm going to deal secondary memory. Dear student, in my today's session, I'm going to deal with what is primary memory, what is the use of primary memory, and what are the advantages of primary memory. Along with that, I'm going to discuss read only memory. Dear student, in my next session, I'm going to deal with random access memory. Along with that, I'm going to deal with secondary memory. But in today's session, I'm going to deal with primary memory. In that, I'm going to explain what is read-only memory. Moving further, I'm going to have primary memory. Now tell me, what is primary memory? And how the primary memory is going to work. So here the primary memory is also called main memory. Primary memory is also called main memory. And the size of the main memory is always less compared to secondary memory. Here the memory units are the storage area in the computer. The term primary memory is usually refers to main memory of the computer system, whereas the word storage, that is always refers to the secondary storage device. And some of the examples for secondary storage devices are CD, floppy disk or tapes. These are the some of the examples for secondary storage device. And dear student, whenever I say it is memory, just remember that it is always primary memory or main memory. And it is present inside your CPU. And this is the internal memory. It is present inside the CPU. Here CPU is nothing but the central processing unit, and it is called internal memory. And the size of the memory is small, but the execution speed of the instruction is high. So it is called faster memory. And the primary memories are called static device. Now tell me why it is called static device. Because in primary memory, we are not going to have any rotating device. For that reason, it is called static memory. So here, primary memory is also called static memory or static device. The main memory is also called physical memory, which refers to the chip. Remember that the main memory is also called physical memory. Why it is called physical memory? Because it is reside inside the chip. So here chip is nothing but the integrated circuit. I repeat, here chip is nothing but the integrated circuit. Dear student, here you can able to see the chip. Here chip is nothing but the integrated circuit, and these chips are made by using semiconductor. I repeat, here these chips are made by using semiconductor. The primary memory is also called main memory, or it's also called physical memory. And the primary memory is classified into two types, that is read-only memory and random access memory. Dear student, in my today's session, I'm going to discuss read-only memory, and in my next session, I'm going to discuss random access memory. Moving further, I'm going to have read-only memory. Now tell me, what is read-only memory and which material is used to design read-only memory? So here the read-only memory is made by using semiconductor. Here read-only memory is responsible for reading the data, but here you cannot able to write the data on read-only memory. Here the name itself indicates that you can able to read the data, but you cannot able to write the data. In ROM, the information is burnt into the ROM chip at manufacturing time. That means during the manufacturing time, the information is burnt into the ROM. And once the data has been written into the ROM chip, it cannot be erased, but it can be read. That means during manufacturing time, the data or informations are written into the read-only memory. By using these data, user can able to read the data, but the user cannot able to erase or modify or write the data onto the read-only chip. When we switch off the computer, the content of the ROM are not erased. That means when we turn off our computer system, the content on the ROM does not erase. That means the content on the ROM remains as it is. For that reason, The ROM is used to store the instruction that is required by the computer system during start or boot. That means the read-only memory holds the instruction that is required by the computer system during start or during boot. So here the ROM holds the instruction that is required by the computer system to start or boot. For that reason, the read-only memory is called permanent memory, or it is called non-volatile memory. So it is called permanent memory. So here ROM is also called non-volatile memory. That means here we can able to read the data and we cannot able to write, and all the datas are written during the manufacturing, and here we are going to use the predefined data, but we cannot able to write the data onto the read only chip. Here we can able to read the data, but we cannot able to write the data onto the read-only memory chip. Moving further, I'm going to have the different types of ROM. That is programmable read-only memory, erasable programmable read-only memory, and electrically erasable programmable read-only memory. That means here the read-only memories are classified into three types. That is programmable read-only memory, that is PROM, and I'm going to have another type, that is erasable programmable read-only memory, that is EPROM, and I'm going to have another type, that is electrically erasable programmable read-only memory, that is EEPROM. Moving further, let's see what is programmable read-only memory. Here, PROM is a memory on which the data can be written only once. That means the PROM is a memory chip where the data is written only once. A variety of PROM chip is that it is not burnt at the manufacturing time. That means whatever the data which is stored on the PROM, and it is not burnt during the manufacturing. That means it is not written during the manufacturing, but can be programmed using PROM programmer or a PROM burner. That means suppose if you want to rewrite the program which is written on the PROM, then you can able to modify or rewrite by using PROM programmer or PROM burner. That means whatever the instruction it is stored on the PROM, it is not written during the manufacturing. And if you want to modify this program, you can able to modify by using PROM programmer or PROM burner. So here PROM is also called non-volatile memory. Moving further, I'm going to have erasable programmable read-only memory. In EPROM, the information can be erased and reprogrammed using special PROM programmer. That means by using EPROM, you can able to rewrite the data. That means in EPROM, you can able to rewrite the data by using programmable read-only memory programmer. So here EPROM is also called non-volatile memory, and here EPROM differs from PROM because in PROM we can able to rewrite the data once. That means PROM, in that the PROM can able to write to only once and cannot be erased. That means in PROM you can able to write the data once and we cannot able to erase the data. But an ultraviolet light used to erase the content of the EPROM. That means if you want to rewrite the EPROM chip once again, then with the help of ultraviolet light you can able to erase the data. So that is the difference between PROM as well as EPROM. That means in PROM once the data is written, then we cannot able to modify, but in EPROM we can able to modify the data with the help of ultraviolet light. Moving further, I'm going to have electrically erasable programmable read only memory. Here electrically erasable programmable read only memory is the recent developed type of memory, and this equivalent to EPROM, that is electrically programmable read only memory. But what's the difference here? It does not require ultraviolet light to erase the content. That means suppose if I want to erase the content of EPROM, then I require ultraviolet light. But in electrically erasable programmable read only memory, we does not require ultraviolet light. It can be erased by exposing to an electrical charge. That means suppose if you want to erase the content of electrically erasable programmable read only memory, then that can be done by using, that means by exposing it to electrical charge. That means if you want to erase the data on the electrically erasable programmable read only memory, then what I want to do, I want to expose it to an electrical charge. It's also called non-volatile in nature, and it is very fast memory comparing to other memory. That means here the electrically erasable programmable read-only memory is faster memory comparing to other memory type. So here the electrically erasable programmable read-only memory is faster memory comparing to other type of ROM. In today's session, we had discussion regarding what is primary memory and what is secondary memory. So memory is classified into two types, primary memory and secondary memory. So here primary memory is once again classified into RAM and ROM. So here ROM is further classified into PROM, EPROM and EEPROM, whereas RAM is classified into two types, that is static RAM and dynamic RAM. Whereas the secondary memory is classified into hard disk, floppy disk, magnetic tape, etc. So dear student, in my today's session we had discussion regarding what is memory. Along with that we discussed what is primary memory. In that we discussed what is read-only memory and the different types of read-only memory, that is erasable programmable read-only memory and electrically erasable programmable read-only memory, and this is called non-volatile memory because whatever the data it is stored on this memory, that is permanent. For that reason it is called non-volatile memory. The program required to start your computer systems are stored inside the read-only memory. Dear student, in my next session, I'm going to deal with what is random access memory. Along with that, I'm going to discuss what is secondary memory and the types of secondary memory. Dear student, keep watching and keep learning. Until then, take care. Thank you.